Whenever people come together to work, you can be sure that at some point in time there's going to be a problem that comes up, some conflicts will arise, and sooner or later you will be in a position that you need to solve these kind of critical situations. This is a challenge for many people, especially for young professionals. Many people don't want to confront other people face to face. They would rather prefer harmony and not needing to put themselves out there to have these difficult conversations. But of course, these difficult conversations are important and often just need to take place. And during my time as a consultant at McKinsey, I learned a simple principle that was aimed to guide young consultants in how to confront clients, how to handle challenging and sensitive situations at work. Oh, hey! Hello everybody and welcome to another coffee break with Firm Learning. My name is Heinrich and on this channel I want to help you be successful in the first years of your career. Doesn't matter if you are a young professional or a recent graduate that will enter the workplace soon. If you're taking any value out of this video at all, please press the like button for the YouTube algorithm and also subscribe to this channel and also hit the notification bell to stay informed on all the future content I have planned out for you. I will release at least one video every Saturday, so stay tuned for that. The inspiration for today's video I got on a conversation that was going on my Instagram channel. In the last days, I posted several pieces of content on how you can actually handle and address difficult and sensitive situations that you might face in your work. And after that, I received messages from many of you sharing situations that you are facing in your work environment or even also in your private life. And then we were having a discussion on what you can actually do in your specific instance. And a gist from it that I'd like to share here, because I believe that many of these problems are very much about how you actually confront the other person and what ways of communication you use in order to make sure that you are addressing the problems in the right way. So as you can imagine, there are many reasons why in the workplace you might find yourself in a sensitive situation. It could either be that maybe you have an argument with a client, he might be unsatisfied with how you resolved a specific instance in your relationship, and there might be now an issue that you would like to solve. Or at least as likely, there might be a colleague of yours whom you have a disagreement with on a personal or a work-related topic, and now you're looking for a way to actually resolve this kind of situation. Whenever there are people involved, it's clear that there's always a big potential for problems, for drama, for sensitive situations, and the question is, how do you actually handle it? And of course, this is not only true for your professional life, for your work life, but at least as true for your private and personal life. What I see many people do in these situations, and this is also true for many associates I work with when being a project lead, people tend to like to write an email. Whenever there's a problem, you write an email to send it to the other person, and this is the way of communication that just many people choose. And there seem to be some rather obvious reasons for that. First of all, it's very often the easiest thing to do. Wherever you are, whenever you have the time, you can just write an email, send it off, and then from your perspective, the problem is solved. At least this is what you think. And then second, also it helps you avoid these tough discussions when you really need to look somebody in the face and having this really heart-to-heart, face-to-face discussion with another person on a topic that might make you feel uncomfortable, on a topic where you know that it's an issue for the other person, that you just do not know how to resolve this. People have a natural tendency to avoid these kind of confrontational situations, and just writing an email often seems to be an easy way out where you can avoid this direct confrontation with your supervisors, with other colleagues, with clients, or with people in your personal life. And many of the messages that you sent me on Instagram reminded me of a prior instance when I was a young consultant at McKinsey and I was facing such a difficult situation with one of my clients whom I was responsible for. And I already sent this client several emails and I was sitting in the team room and complaining to my project lead saying, this person is so difficult to work with, I've already sent him so many emails, he just doesn't reply, or when he replies, he's giving me such a bad time, I really do not know what else to do. And this was the moment where my project lead at that time taught me one of the golden rules of consulting, how you interact with colleagues and clients. And this rule are pretty much three words. It is walk, talk, write. Again, the rule is walk, talk, write. What does it mean? How is this rule to be understood? Well, it is a rule that is supposed to tell you how you should handle these kind of difficult communication situations. And it gives you the priority how you should act. The first priority that you should follow is walk. And with walk, what is meant here is that you are supposed to walk to this person's desk, walk to your client's, to your colleague's desk, and talk to the person face to face. Try to resolve the situation in a face to face conversation. When you look somebody in the face, you have the best opportunity to really understand best the other person's perspective and come to an agreement that works for both sides on the table. And yes, of course, it's not always possible to walk to the other person, and then might just not be feasible to talk to the other person face to face. So the rule again goes walk, talk, write. So if walking is not possible, then the second priority for you is to talk. So this means that in this case, you pick up the phone and you talk to the person on the phone in order to resolve it. And again, while it is a significant difference whether you talk to the person face to face or just on the phone, talking on the phone or maybe on a video conference is the second best thing that you can do. And only if these things are not possible, if they are not feasible, then the third option is to write. Then you can open an email and write whatever thoughts you might have. Though here again, if you write, it might be smart harder to actually then just ask for a phone conversation or for a face-to-face meeting in order to blowing out all your steam while writing it in an email, right? So don't be an email warrior. This is what I mean here. If you need to write an email, try to just use it to have a phone conversation, especially when the topics are difficult and sensitive and there's really a problem that needs to be solved. If you just think about your experience, how dare you then resolve the situations, I hope you agree with me that most of the time it was due to a face-to-face meeting or a phone call and not just by you writing an email, even though of course I understand that in many situations it's just so much easier to write an email than to meet the person face-to-face, especially if you know and expect that the conversation is going to be a difficult one. So looking back at that feedback point that I received as a young consultant from my project lead, this was really a game changer. This principle of walk, talk, write really made a big difference in my professional life. And then when a few years later, I advanced to become a project lead myself, when I had conversations with my associates and they were telling me that they struggled in certain situations, that they struggled when interacting with clients, when then I tried to understand how they have interacted with them, very often the result was that they relied far too much on written communication and just did not make an effort big enough really to go out there and talk to the people in person. So what are your experiences? What do you think? What difficult situations have you already encountered in your professional life? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you what you have already experienced and what your reflections are, what your insights are into how to handle these kind of difficult situations. And again, if there's any value you took out of this video at all, please hit the like button, also subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. And also just to let you know, in the last weeks, I really reactivated my Instagram presence. My Instagram handle is firmlearning as well. If you'd like to become part of my Instagram community, join there as well. At the moment, I'm pretty much posting new content on my Instagram channel several times a day. I'm just so grateful to have all these channels over which I can communicate with you and we can form just this big firm learning community. So thank you for being part of it. I very much appreciate your time. Thanks for watching again. I'm Heinrich from Firm Learning and I wish all of you a great weekend.